Treeyo Permaculture started about 3 years ago.
We really focus on the idea that people have different learning styles. So we really vary the ways we deliver information to make sure that everyone is grasping the idea.
From the beginning, we're going to start thinking differently. You know, we have these traditional paradigms about the environment, about us and nature, and I hope to start to break that down.
What appear to be very separate individual parts from all over the place have come together, made these connections that normally are invisible. You're not going and telling people what to do, you're helping them see the interconnections and giving them this sort of checklist to make whatever they want. So when we're talking about cycles and repairing cycles, you want to be able to identify these broken cycles. So that's one of the ways, and you know that it's a mineral issue. So then you need to go into further research.
It's being a facilitator of a learning experience where much of the information is already set inside of people. Just underneath the leaf layer, you'll find this really dark, rich smell, and it smells like the forest. Mm. What is that? That is,
it smells like mushroom.
Yeah, it's actinomycetes, which is a type of mushroom.
They know their stuff, and it's just the clarity of the way they teach, the way they speak.
We're just going to let this process sort of unfold naturally. You're going to have questions. The chicken manure.
Pretty interesting. My first composting experience. But now I know what an integral part of everything it is.
Can dry it out.
It's actually quite fun, clearing all this stuff out and making your own compost pile.
So we need some sawdust. Who's on sawdust?
I'll get sawdust. I haven't done sawdust yet.
Hi, I'm Sumina. I'm half Dutch, half Pakistani. I just want to be self-sufficient first, basically. I don't want to depend too much on the supermarket, outside world.
You start to see where the inputs and the outputs match up well.
It just makes sense. It just seems so logical. It seems natural.
So the goal of these courses is to get people to understand and know these tools.
I've got beehives. I'm going to put them in the protection of the hill.
I'm going to put the donkey and cart also somewhere around the barn.
So this is our zone 5 anyway.
So that they can make good decisions when they go back to whatever career or industry or town.
I'm Gregor and I come from Germany. I decided to take the PDC because we are about to create a community garden in our hometown, Dresden. That's where I can use some of the things I learned here.
So at the end of the 72-hour course, there's a design presentation based on an actual piece of land that you've had the chance to observe.
So people, even though they're learning about the design process, they're actually within it at the same time. So essentially, you start with the visioning, how you want your life to be during the implementation of this design. So it gives you that grounding. Then you have your assessment period.
Because permaculture isn't just going out onto a piece of land and starting to dig.
The reality is we have a much wider resource base than we think we do.
That's the first thing, protracted and thoughtful observation, where you stand back and you don't make judgments at first, but you just observe and you have this context of soil, water, trees.
But still these people have this inherent need to be somewhere around trees.
Yeah.
It's gotta be there, it's gotta be something inherent.
It really preserves your sanity, I think.
You learn about the hydrological cycle. If you know how the water works, you'll know where to catch it.
You wanna make sure you're getting observations throughout the season and throughout generations. This is something that you want to do for your generation, for the next generation.
Permaculture is a way of empowering every element.
When you're regenerating land, you're just helping it do what it's already doing, basically.
To walk into a forest and it grows perfectly well by itself.
So now you start playing with all these ideas of how can you interconnect these resources, how can they support each other, and how can waste streams become fuel streams for another system.
I thought the chicken tractor was well known because to use mobile structures, I think it's a great idea, and I had never thought of that in a place in the garden which is full of weed or it's just overgrown. You leave them there till they've enjoyed the food. In the meantime, they're scratching and they're feeding the soil and they're just preparing the soil for a later stage. And you can do that by moving it.
Using biological resources.
Using biological resources. Yeah.
The patterns of nature can be applied to anything from how we organize ourselves in society, how we create monetary systems, how we build buildings, how we garden. It's applicable to so many different disciplines.
If you put mulch on a garden bed, then you bring fertility into the ground.
So from there, we get into the heart and soul of the course.
And then as you get more into it, it starts refining, you start seeing these beautiful connections that maybe you wouldn't have identified if you had just gone and looked at the land and started to design.
Here it's a very wet area with all the ponds and...
One of the design principles is diversity. So in a course of ours, we really try to teach to as many different learning styles. We include things like hands-on exercises, interactive games and exercises that bring the material alive.
We are looking at different species and we are looking up the details of the correct time of year to propagate them. You don't necessarily need to grow everything from seed.
Yeah, and it's always nice to work together with people and when you see how quickly work can be done.
I can't remember it. I'll get it in a minute though, I will, I promise.
Natural building is a perfect example of that learning curve in that the early plastering layers, for example, you don't have to be perfect in your ratios of clay to sand to straw. But it can be a little rough. It can have some cracking. It's all fine. It's just going to give more teeth for that next layer to be able to fit in.
You'll know it's work if you put it on your fingers and sort of coach your fingers. If it just runs right off, it needs to sit more.
Can I have one more for you?
So, but if it'll kind of coat, and it's almost like a big paint.
Yeah.
And then you can use that.
What I love about natural building is to get my hands in the soil and to feel the earth, to feel the materials.
You get a better eye and a feel for the clay. So then you can make a better mix. So then that second layer needs to be thinner and a little bit more refined than that first layer.
You know, plastered on the house and just to feel the texture and smooth it out. And
so you can start off with no experience and make a beautiful building, a beautiful finished plaster, and you haven't wasted any of your time.
Then it got stretched and it grew out and it turned into a beautiful sunshine octopus.
Oh, yeah.
If you do it with the permaculture systems, every time you do something, it's building on the last thing you did. So it's so efficient in creating momentum, satisfaction, connection.
Love the world!
I love the way things have been brought together. You have survival skills. I see it as survival skills.
And making sure that you're taking care of the soil.
It's about reproducing microorganisms.
It's making sure that water enters your site and then leaves it cleaner than what it came in, that there's more perennial vegetation and more shade and more food and more abundance.
It is possible to make a system that is truly efficient, that is truly cycling and not wasteful,
which will help to turn deserts around, to make agricultural systems productive again, and to transform society into one that's cooperative.
You're tapped into this greater community of support.
It's been wonderful actually to meet people from all around the world. Yeah, there's such a diverse mix.
Keeping in contact with all of these people and helping relations with this network to help it grow.
Coming to do this PDC has been about getting a little bit of practical experience.
I'm so grateful for all of this, the way you're teaching, it's unbelievable, and about this whole group.
It just made me happier, it gave me hope, organized the world better, you know, it would make things a lot easier.
People just feel better when they work in a regenerative system.